Hi friends, welcome back to God of Gizmos. My name is Satish Kumar Purswani. Today we are going to talk about how to create mono using create method. So I hope you have watched my earlier video where I have talked about how to create mono and flux using different methods that are available. So that video actually went on for about 16 minutes. So I will try to keep this video as short as possible. And what I've did is I've now thought to keep mono and flux as separate videos so that it completes out soon. So without wasting much time, let's get started. So as you can see on my screen, I've created this class called mono create, and we will be creating a mono using create method. So what I will do is I will just create mono of integer, okay, and we will name integer mono, and we will say mono dot create. And if you can see, mono dot create actually accepts monosync, and monosync is an interface which is having these methods with, that is success that is nullable, success with nullable value that can be passed, an error method, and these three methods as well. Okay, now what I will do is I will create I will try to set the value, okay, in it. Just a second, we'll use integer monosync, and I will pass the value, that is we can say 5, okay, and we can directly do a subscribe to this method, integer.mono subscribe, and whatever the value is coming in, we will try to print that value. Okay, what we will do is we will also accept the throwable if there is any error that is being emitted by this mono, so that we come to know what is the error that is being emitted. Okay, so I will say this is our our error. Okay, now and I will actually concatenate that variable throwable over here. Okay, so I think we are good. Let's run this. Okay, yeah, we are done. We are getting the value as 5, whichever value we are passing. And even if you pass nothing, it will still be working fine, because the success value actually accepts nothing, that is empty value or nullable value can be passed. That's what I've shown you. Okay, I've emptied the value in success, so you can see our program has completed successfully, but there is no value that is being printed, and you can actually throw an error as well. Okay, so we will say a new runtime exception, or if you want exception, this is my exception. Okay, and what I will do is I will try to run this, and we should get the exception. Okay, so you can see there is an exception coming in. This is our error which is printed from here, and then the exception class name, and this is what the string that we have passed. Okay, now you will see you will say that there is one more method in flux of create method there is one more method which is called complete method, but that is not the case with mono, because that the reason is mono will actually will contain only one object. And as soon as that one object is emitted, it will actually send the event which is on complete, and we are not able to see that, right? We are not able to see that event. So what I will do is I will try to execute this again so that you get to know we are not seeing that event. But what if we want to see that event? So what I will do is there are two ways. One is you can use dot log to see what all events, what all, how mono is working. So log is actually used for debugging purpose as well. and it is advisable not to actually promote the code using long. And what I will try to do is I will try to execute this for you so that you can see. Okay, in the log you can see as soon as first element is emitted, we are getting an onComplete method. Now if you do not want to actually use the log, what you can do is you can use the onComplete method, okay, in the subscribe method, so that we can say now, let me copy this line and just change the line. Okay, this is our complete event, and of course we will not be having a throwable coming in, and this is just end of statement. So I will try to execute this again. Okay, so as you can see, as soon as one is emitted, we are getting the complete event, and we can see the complete event being logged. Hope you like this video. Hope this video is informative and useful to you. So if you like this video, please give a thumbs up to this video and subscribe to my channel. In my next video, I will try to cover flux.create method, and I will also try to cover flux.fromString or from array method, that is there, and few other methods. So stay tuned to my channel. Hope you like this video, and thank you so much for watching.